There are many maps throughout history, some holding more significance than others. Here are five memorable maps in the field of geoinformatics. Before we begin, remember to subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up and remember to click on the notification bell to receive our latest news. If you want to learn more about geoinformatics, be sure to enroll in our MOOC. The link is in the description box below. Now let's get started. Ptolemy's world projection. Claudius Ptolemy was a mathematician, astronomer, geographer, astrologer, and a poet. Having written several significant scientific treatises, including the Almagest, the Geographia, and the Tetrabiblios, his maps were featured in his treatise named the Geographia, also known as the Cosmographia. It is a compilation of geographic coordinates for the world known to the Roman Empire. The Geographia contains three sections divided into eight books. Book 1 on cartography treaties describes the principles used to assemble Ptolemy's data. Book 2 to the beginning of Book 7 is the gazetteer section, with the longitudes and latitudes for all places with geographical features in Ptolemy's work. The latter part of Book 7 contains details of the three projections used for the construction of the maps. And Book 8 is the atlas containing a single, large, less detailed overall map and several detailed regional maps known to the Roman Empire. Mercator's World Map of 1569. After Ptolemy, Gerhardus Mercator is another influential figure in the field of mapping. He was a 16th century German-Flemish cartographer, geographer, and cosmographer, known for creating the 1569 world map based on rhomb lines, something still used today in nautical maps. Titled the Nova et Acta Orbis Terrae Descriptio ad Usum Navigatium Emadate Accommodata, Mercator presented the geographical knowledge of the time in a form recognizable to sailors. The map projected the world into 18 separate sheets spanning 60 degrees longitude each. The first known copy resides in the Bibliothèque Nationale de France, which has been digitized into 13 different images, not corresponding to the 18 sheets as produced by Mercator. The second copy was discovered in Stadtbibliothek of Breslau, but was destroyed by a fire in 1945. A third copy was found in a map collection from the archives of the Amerbach family and had been given to the University of Basel. It is currently the cleanest version of the existing copies. In 1932, a copy had been discovered in an auction sale in Luzerne and is now residing in the map collection of Maritime Museum in Rotterdam. Since then, reproductions have been made from these maps. John Snow's map of cholera cases in London's epidemic of 1854. It was believed, in 1854, that diseases such as cholera and the plague were spread by bad miasma. However, Snow was skeptical at the time and gathered verbal accounts from residents of London to track the outbreak. Through his investigation and analysis of evidence, he plotted out his findings and narrowed the source of outbreak to a water pump on Broad Street. His method of investigation is similar to what is done on a GIS today. Although he could not conclusively prove the danger of the water from the pump, his studies on the pattern of deaths and sickness persuaded the local council to disable the pump, which brought about the end of the outbreak. Minard's map of Napoleon's Russian campaign of 1812. Charles Joseph Minard was a civil engineer renowned for his information graphics on engineering and statistics. It could be said his works are the beginning of what we know as infographics today. Minard's cartographic representation of the losses suffered by Napoleon in his Russian campaign of 1812 must be the most well-known of his works. Though this is seen as more of an imagery than a map, it tracks Napoleon's army during their campaign from the Polish-Russian border, with the thick lines representing the size of his army during the journey. From this map, viewers can easily picture the severity and the reason behind the losses suffered by Napoleon's troops. It displays six types of data within a 2D environment: number of troops, distance traveled, temperature, latitude, longitude, direction of journey, and location. It supplied the viewers with the information in graphical format instead of merely words on paper. This type of visual representation for flow is later known as a Sankey diagram, most prominently used to illustrate energy and material flows. NASA's Earth at Night maps. Launched in 2011 by NASA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, and Department of Defense, the SUMI National Polar Orbiting Partnership satellite captures images of Earth at night. From these images, a flat map was produced in both color and grayscale. The lights on these images and maps often signify congregations of man-made structures. The brighter the lights, the more likely it is a city. Apart from cities, the images also capture other phenomena such as forest fires. An example of this took place in Australia. When NASA released their images in 2013, viewers commented on the abundance of lights in Western Australia and the New Territories. Examining the image closely, which was captured in October 2012, showed a mosaic map presenting burnt urban areas. Thus, it was clear that the released image actually captured the bushfire while in progress. And those are the five memorable maps in Geoinformatics. Have we missed any? What are some of the most memorable maps you've seen? Leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. If you want to learn more about Geoinformatics, enroll in our MOOC available on edX. The link is in the description box below.